Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of design of steel structure. In the previous video, we have seen introduction to tension members and we have seen what are the different failures of tension members. So in the current video, we are going to solve one problem related to design of design tensile strength for plate members. So the statement for the given numerical is as, so determine the strength of 120F8, that is Indian standard flat, connected to 12 mm thick gusset plate with bolts as shown. So details of the figure are given in the problem itself. You have to use M16 4.6 grade of bolts. So already in design of bolted connection, we have seen what are the nomenclatures or what are the notations that are adapted for solving these particular problems. So here itself in the problem, these details are mentioned. Correct? So initially always we are starting with writing of your given data. So first step in the solution is always given data. So given data, and again we are identifying the given data from statement which is given for the numerical. So initially determine the design tensile strength of 120F8. So that is the designation adapted for Indian standard flat. So we can write here Indian standard flat 120/8. Correct? So 120 mm is the width and 8 mm is the thickness for Indian standard flat. Then next, it is connected to 12 mm thick gusset plate. So here gusset plate is mentioned 12 mm to which 8 mm thick flat is connected. Then next is bolts, with the help of bolts, details of the bolts are given. So it is M16 4.6 grade. So from this data, you can write M16 is given, therefore diameter of bolt is equal to 16 mm. These details you can identify. Then next, diameter of hole. So generally clearance of 2 mm we are giving for 16 mm diameter. So this will be equal to 18 mm. Again using grade 4.6, you can identify ultimate strength of bolt and yield strength of bolt. So you will write ultimate strength of bolt FUB is equal to 400 MPa. This value can be written. Correct? So details regarding the plate strength are not mentioned. So we are assuming that plate strength is equal to FUP value, I am considering is equal to always high strength plate 410 MPa. Correct? Now from figure, these details regarding your pitch distance, edge distance, end distance is mentioned. Already that definition we have seen. When you are measuring center to center distance between two consecutive bolt along the load direction, it is defined as your pitch distance. When this distance is measured across your or perpendicular to your load direction, it is called as your gauge distance. So in this figure, you can understand it is a chain type of bolting. Two rows of the bolts are used and here total six number of bolts are adapted. So this is the direction of loading. So along the direction of loading, center to center distance, that is given as 60 mm. So you can write pitch value is equal to 60 mm. Correct? Again, if that distance is measured perpendicular to direction of force, this is the perpendicular direction. So that is equal to again 60 value. So I am writing gauge distance is also given as 60 mm. Correct? Again, this particular will be your end distance where your plate is going to end or terminate. And this will be your edge distance. So edge and end distance, both values are equal to 30. Usually the specification for edge and end distance is same. That is usually 1.5 times of diameter of hole or 1.7 times of diameter of hole. So that value E dash is equal to or E equal to is given as 30 mm. So these are the details as per statement. And again, as per your figure, we have defined the given data for the numerical. Now you need to calculate design tensile strength. So tensile strength or tensile force is nothing but when force is applied axially and the member elongates or yields, it is generally coming under category of tension force. So here certain tensile force for flat 120F is applied, for which you need to calculate the strength. Getting? So strength for tension member is given by this particular formulas. We have already seen the failure is because of yielding of gross section. So first type of failure TDG. So design tensile strength due to yielding of gross section. So yielding of gross section, this is the first failure type for your tension member. Second is rupture of critical section. So rupture of critical section. And third is block shear failure, when entire block is going to tear out from the connected plate. Usually this third kind of failure is only because of less edge distance or end distance and sometimes less pitch distance between your bolts, because of which the block is going to tear out from the connected part. So this is the formulas that are to be adapted for this solution. You need to calculate TDG, TDN, TDB1 and TDB2, and the minimum of all these four values, or minimum of these four values, is going to be your design tensile strength. So initially, starting with the very first step, first value TDG, that is equal to design tensile strength due to yielding of gross section. So this value is given as A gross multiplied by yield strength of material divided by gamma M0. So gamma M0 we are adapting from table number 5, page number 30. So gamma M0 is value 1.1, gamma M1 is 1.25. Correct? So initially starting with A gross value. So I am writing A gross equals to, so A gross connected plate 120 into 8. So 120 multiplied by 8 is equal to 960 mm square. This is the area. So putting the values, design tensile strength TDG will be equal to 960 multiplied by yield strength is 250 divided by partial safety factor 1.1 divided by 1000. So we are getting answer is equal to 218.18 kilonewton. So yield strength for plate is 250. Ultimate strength for plate you have written is 410. So you can write here FYP is equal to 250 MPa. Correct? So first strength of your plate, because of yielding of gross section, we are getting as 218.18 kilonewton, that is TDG value. Now next formula we are adapting for rupture of critical section. Already in the introduction part we have seen, for bolted connection, we are drilling holes in your member which is to be connected to gusset plate, and because of drilling of this particular hole, there is reduction in the area. Correct? So we are knowing formula for stress is calculated as force divided by area. So as there will be reduction in area, there will be increment in your stress value. So in comparison with this particular, suppose I am considering section vertical here. This section, suppose AA, will be subjected to higher stresses compared with section which is not having any kind of bolt drilled holes. Correct? So at this particular critical section, I am going to calculate the design tensile strength due to rupture of critical section, that is TDN value. So for which second value TDN, rupture strength for critical section, value is given as 0.9 into AN into FU divided by gamma M1. So again, partial safety factor, table number 5, page number 30, gamma M1 is 1.25. FU value already we have written for plates, it is 410 MPa because it is high strength plates. Now A net value, correct? So two types of areas are coming into consideration, A gross and A net. Gross area is without deducting any kind of holes, whereas net area is by considering or by deducting the holes along that particular critical section. Correct? So here for this 1-1 section, you may consider, you may see that two number of holes are going to come into picture. So these two holes are to be deducted. Again, diameter given is 16, for which the hole diameter is DH value is 18 mm. So in short, from entire width of 120 mm, you need to deduct two times the hole diameter. Correct? So I am writing A net equals to total width of the plate is 120, correct? That is given here 120, 60 plus 2 times your edge distance. 120 is the entire width. Here also we have taken total value 120. But now this 120 is deducted because of drilling of holes. So 120 minus N into DH. What is the formula? Formula is width minus N multiplied by DH. So N is number of holes. So number of holes for section 1-1s are 2 multiplied by diameter of hole. Diameter of hole is equal to 18 mm. So diameter of hole is 18 mm. So this is the width value, again multiplied with thickness 8 equals to. So net area you are getting equals to 672 mm square. So here you can observe that there is reduction in the area. This was 960, which is now deducted or reduced to 672 mm square. So putting these values in your formula TDN, I am writing TDN equals to 0.9 multiplied by, then A net value is 672 into ultimate strength of plate is 410 divided by partial safety factor M1 is 1.25. So I am getting divided by 1000 again. I am getting answer as 193.54 kilonewtons. So this is the second strength of your plate. First was gross yielding, second was rupture due to critical section. Now coming towards the third type of failure, that is block shear failure. Correct. So for block shear failure, these two formulas you have to add up. Now in formula, you can observe that four types of areas are to be calculated. Two areas are for shear direction and two areas are for tension direction. And already in the introductory lecture, we have seen what is shear area and what is your tension area. Shear area is always calculated parallel to direction of loading. Correct. So here in this figure, we'll draw that particular block shear pattern. So I will be joining all the centers of the bolts. So this hatching portion is nothing but it is going to tear out from the entire section. Correct. So this is the four direction. So for four direction, parallel sides are two. So these two parallel sides are nothing but this will be your shear area. Shear area. Again here also it will be your shear area. Correct. And direction perpendicular to your force, that will be your tension area. So this is your tension area. Correct. So just calculating these values now. For this calculation, you will be requiring initially AVG value. So I am writing AVG. Now AVG stands for, A is area, V stands for shear, G stands for gross. So gross shear area. So in figure you have seen shear area is likewise. So what is the entire width here? Width is nothing but equal to 30 plus 60 plus 60. Correct. So I am writing AVG equal to, so 60, 60, 120 plus 30, that is 150. So gross area will be equal to 150 multiplied by 8 value. 150 multiplied by 8 value. So I am getting answer. So that is 24, sorry. As the area is twice, you need to multiply it with 2 value. So it is 2400 mm square. Here you can see that this is your edge distance 30 plus 60 plus 60. So entire width will be equal to 150 multiplied by thickness is 8 mm. Correct. So 150 into 8, twice you need to consider. So therefore it is multiplied with 2. So total area you are getting 2400 mm square. It is the shear area where we have not deducted any kind of hole. Therefore I am writing G value, that is gross. So similarly, you need to calculate net area also. So that is denoted as AVN equals to. So again, same A area, V shear, and N stand for net. So net shear area, this was gross shear area. So for net shear area, the width value is going to be same. It is 150. Width is what? It is 150. So number of diameter of hole that are deducted. So you can observe, simple calculation is there. You need to calculate number of holes minus 0.5. So here you can observe complete diameter. This is again complete diameter, and here it is only radius. So in short, it will be what? D plus D, and this is 0.5. Correct? So it will be 2.5. So 2.5 times of diameter of hole. So 150 minus 2.5 into 18. Diameter of hole is 18. Multiplied by thickness is what? It is 8 thickness. Now hole multiplied by 2 value. Because again, 2 shear area. So I am getting AVN as 1680 mm square. Correct. So I will repeat this. For net calculation, what you have to do? Just measure number of holes. So this is 1, 2, 3. Minus 0.5. So 3 minus 0.5 is 2.5. So N value is 2.5 times of diameter of hole. Getting? So net okay, multiplied by 8 value, and twice area you are considering, therefore multiplied by 2, you will be getting 1680 mm square. So two shear areas, that is gross and net, we have calculated. In gross without deducting, and for net calculation, diameter of holes are deducted. Correct. Now next, after AVG and AVN, next calculation is related with your ATG value. So I am writing ATG equals to, so again here area, tension, and this is gross. So gross tension area, we have seen tension area is always perpendicular to force direction. So this is the force direction to which perpendicular is what? This is the width, and that width is equal to your one pitch distance. So it will be equal to gross area as 60 multiplied by 8. So it will be equal to 480 mm square. Correct. It is equal to 480 mm square. Again, here no need to multiply it with 2 because single tension area is there. Here the shear area was twice, therefore we have multiplied with 2. for tension only single value 60 into 8 without deducting diameter of hole. So will be equal to 480 mm square. Now again ATN equals to, so it is again net tension area, correct? So for net tension area, your diameter of hole is to be deducted. Getting? So here half of the radius and again here half of the radius. So it is one complete diameter is to be deducted. Correct? In the figure you can see here radius value and here also radius value. So radius plus radius is nothing but it is your one complete diameter. So I am writing 60 minus 1 multiplied by 18. N value is what? N value is one complete diameter multiplied by diameter of hole is 18 into thickness is 8. So I am getting value as 336. So 336 mm square. Getting? So apart from this, you will be requiring Fy. Fy is 250. Fu value is 410. Gamma m0, it is equal to 1.1 value. And gamma m1, that is 1.25. So putting this all parameters in TdB1 and TdB2, you are getting value as TdB1 equals to, I am writing the answer directly, 411.69 kilonewton, and TdB2 equals to, so the value is 388.44 kilonewton. So here for calculation of design tensile strength, we have calculated four value. This is A, suppose first, this is second B, this is C, and here is the D value. So design tensile strength for Indian standard flat 120 by 8 mm will be minimum of these four values. So you can observe the least value is there. I think so it is 193.54. Correct? So design tensile strength. Design tensile strength of 120F8 equals to, so that is rupture due to critical section, TDN as 193.54 kilonewton. So this is the final answer. Design tensile strength as 193.54. So in short, for a load up to 193.54, your section is not going to fail. Before, if the load will be exceeding value of 193, then it is going to fail because of rupture of critical section. So here the calculation or design steps are going to remain same, except calculation for your rupture strength because of critical section, it is going to change, and this varies according to your type of section, whether it is threaded rod, whether it is Indian standard flats, or whether it is an angle section. Based on that only your numerical is going to be there. So here in design of tension members, two types of numericals we are going to see. Either it will be analysis type of problem or it will be design type of problem. So this particular is an analysis type of problem where you have calculated the forces. In design type of problems, forces will be given. For given force, you need to calculate the design tensile strength, or you need to calculate before calculating that, you need to go with design of connection, and after that your values of TDG, TDN, TDB1 and TDB2 is to be calculated. So here the numerical is completed. In the next video, we shall be starting with some of the numericals from university question papers. So thank you. Thank you very much.